Hi, I'm Kelly.
And I'm Amanda. We're here to talk to you about the hub. It's a scoring structure in the center of the field and is shared between alliances.
The hub consists of an upper hub and a lower hub. Cargo scored in the upper hub is worth more than cargo scored in the lower hub. Each cargo is a 9.5-inch diameter oversized tennis ball, which is either red
or blue.
They will get fuzzy with use, so make sure you anticipate the change and test accordingly. Fuzzy cargo will be used in official gameplay.
Cargo with large gouges in the fabric will be retired.
Both the upper and lower hub are designed to have cargo exit randomly. Counting cargo is handled by a combination of infrared and color detection sensors from Rockwell Automation.
If a team scores 20 or more cargo into the hub, they'll get the cargo bonus. And if 4 cargo are scored during auto, the threshold drops to 18.
Cargo exiting the upper hub is likely to bounce or roll away from the structure. The spread is wide and will vary. Be careful not to catch cargo exiting the upper hub. Doing so could incur a penalty.
Generally, the upper hub processes cargo in about 4 to 7 seconds, and the lower hub in about 3 to 7 seconds. If there is only one cargo in there, though, it may take longer.
A web of chain is suspended inside the lower hub and is used to retain cargo, but cargo entered forcefully may still bounce out. If your robot extends into the lower hub, it may get caught, so be careful of the chain.
Adjacent to the hub are the tarmacs, where robots start the match. Tarmacs are a little cozy. Alliances may have to shift their robot starting locations depending on the size of their partners.
A series of cable protectors run from the scoring table side of the field to the nearest lower exit of the hub. These cable protectors are different from previous years. They're less than an inch tall and aren't perpendicular to the field border. See the manual for a diagram of the field layout. Have fun!
Good luck, teams!